Welcome back to Ring of Fire. I'm Mike Papantonio. For decades, front groups for corporate America have been trying to sell us the idea that we need tort reform. And this effort that started almost four decades ago is still going strong today. Truth is, it's a lie. Joining me now to talk about that lie is Linda Lipsen, the CEO of the American Association for Justice. Linda, the great myth. You've had the U.S. Chamber of Commerce and ALEC and Allied Associated Industries convince the American public that they should simply give away their right to go to court, because if you do that, corporate America is going to make more money and there's going to be a trickle-down effect and it's going to be good for everybody. Wow. I mean, really?
I was right. I mean, people want to buy quality products. They don't want to have dangerous products into the stream going into the stream of commerce.
Yeah.
And what these companies should do, what the chamber should do, what ALEC should do, all these different groups that are devoted to getting rid of individuals' rights, what they all should do is, instead of spending money on lobbyists in Washington, is they should make their products safe, and that's going to save them money in the long run.
There has been an all-out attack on the jury system, on the right to be able to go to court, because the industry understands they can win in Washington, they can out-lobby everybody in Washington, they can spend more money than everybody in Washington, they can do away with regulations, they can do away with the need for them to self-police, they can control the media to where the media won't tell the story. So the last thing, if they could only do away with the jury system, then by golly, they'll be able to get away with the whole nine yards, won't they?
That's right, and that's why the jury system is so valuable. It's because, you know, you can be treated, your individual family member or your neighbor can be treated the same way as, you know, a CEO from industry. And what the public believes right now is that everything's rigged, that Washington is rigged against them, that regulations are rigged against them, that what's not rigged against them is a jury of their peers. And it is the reason why corporate America is going after it so desperately.
And so what we have is we have Aetna, AT&T, Bristol-Myers Squibb, Pfizer, GlaxoSmithKline, Merck, all the usual suspects who continually create products that either cause injury, products that kill people, products that defraud mom and pop out of their pension programs. These are the people who have put the most money into convincing the average American that if you'll simply give up your right to go to trial, the prices on products are going to get better and there's going to be a great trickle-down effect for you. For example, talk about some of these individual companies. Tell us what kind of problems some of these companies have.
I got to tell you just one example that happened last week. The Chamber of Commerce brought in their star witness, which the CEO from a company called Blitz Gas Can, to tell the committee of members of Congress that they had to go bankrupt because of a trial lawyer pursuing justice for its client, for their client. Okay. Turns out that the gas can, which has is an exploding hazard, that the gas can itself, the fix that would prevent it explosions would have cost 4 cents a gas can. The fellow that came to testify basically said that the reason why he didn't spend 4 cents to make that gas can safe, to make that gas can not incinerate kids and family members, the reason why he didn't do it was because he thought that if he did it, that it would encourage more misuse. It was a ridiculous moment.
But
it was a ridiculous moment and stopped everyone in their tracks.
Well, you know, Linda, I'd love to say that it's only the Republicans buying into that, but it's not. You have Democratic senators and congressmen that are getting so much money from the industry that they'll listen to an argument like that and say, gee, you know, that really makes great sense. But let me move the topic here. You've got an organization called, it's called CJRG. Now, if you look at where the money comes from, this very secretive organization, again, traditional media has not figured out that when they get a press release from the CJRG, that they're getting it from industry the same industry who creates drugs that kill people, products, the defective products that kill people, and the typical journalist working for traditional media never takes the time to follow the money, do they? And because of that, we get a bad story, don't we?
Well, that's true. It's not just this one group. It's ALEC, it's the Chamber, it's all of these organizations that you mentioned have their own lobby teams. It's there are hordes of representatives from industry that try to convince Congress, the public alike, that the lawsuits themselves are the dangers, not the dangerous products. And that's just wrong.
So what we see with this industry more than ever, it's almost like the Tea Party industry, Linda. You almost have, when the Tea Party came out, we started saying, well, gee, this is all grassroots. These are people who really care about the Constitution. They really are honest about their position. And then come to find out, all of the money was coming from inheritance billionaires that were pumping billions of dollars in making up this organization, this grassroots organization. The industry here, Chamber of Commerce, Merck, Chrysler, Citibank, DuPont, they've done the same thing by trying to create this appearance of having a grassroots movement on this idea of civil justice reform, haven't they?
Yes, that's absolutely true, although there are some within the Tea Party that are absolutely fundamentalist about the Constitution in a good way. And they think about the same thing about the Second Amendment as they do about the Seventh Amendment right to trial by jury. And several of the Tea Party folks have gone to the floor of the House and the Senate and talked about the jury trial and how it is not Congress that should be usurping that basic right. So there are some Tea Party folks that are also on the side of jury trials.
But to bring it down for a landing, the money that's behind this appearance of this grassroots reform is, for example, it's Merck. Okay, Merck, they're the same people who brought us Vioxx, killed thousands and thousands of Americans. We saw them hiding documents, destroying documents, phoning up clinical data. So they're the people who want reform. We saw W.R. Grace. They're one of the people who want reform. They're the same people who brought us asbestos that has killed tens and tens of thousands of Americans. Of course they want reform. They don't want to have to go to trial and be held responsible. Or how about BP? Now, this is a beautiful one. BP is one of the companies that's trying to say that hide their money, not so we can't see that the money goes from BP to the grassroots organization. BP destroyed an entire ecosystem in the Gulf of Mexico, killed 11 people, probably has poisoned and made ill thousands of people more. And so, of course, they don't want somebody to be able to go to court. But why is it, Linda, that mainstream media does not have the damn sense or the backbone and character to talk about these stories?
You know, I don't know. It's a continual frustration. I believe it's just being inundated by these messages on and on and on that it's not the companies that are guilty. It's the individual family member or your neighbor that's had the audacity to fight back against corporate America. And that's just wrong. And, you know, we now have a website called takejusticeback.org and .com, and we're encouraging folks, if they want to learn about their rights, to go to the website and take justice back.
Linda, talk about it. First of all, as we've explained in the intro here, you probably are one of the most effective lobbyists in the business on behalf of consumers. Part of your idea was to come up with this product, this website, where a person who wants to know the truth can get to the truth. What do you have on a website like that people can follow?
Well, we have stories of individual stories of courage, where individuals have looked at the face of corporate greed and said, no, I'm gonna fight back. We have examples of Congress, congressional efforts to take away people's rights and how you can get involved and how you can ask Congress not to do that. We also are trying to educate journalists and others to how important the jury system is and how it is something to be cherished and to be preserved.
Well, okay, first of all, one thing that's part of this story is when you look at the numbers, when you look at where all this money comes from, as I pointed out, it comes from the baby billionaires, the inheritance babies who want to do away with the civil justice process because they own the pharmaceutical companies, they own the oil companies, they own a lot, and so they don't want somebody to go to trial. But at the same time, you've had this movement that has convinced people, for example, the Chamber of Commerce has convinced people that this is a mom and pop effort. Truth is, the average donation to something like this is something like between $600 to $1 million. Isn't that the average donor that puts money into this movement to reform the civil justice process?
You know, it's not the small companies that are in the major players. It's the huge multinational companies that are the major players. And they hide behind the small companies and say it's all about mom and pop when it's not. I mean, there's so much about this effort that just isn't on the level. Really, what consumers want is they want safety for their families. They want to have, they want to buy safe products. They want to understand them in the marketplace. And then they want, if something happens to them, they want to be able to pursue their remedies in court. They want a fair shake. That's all they're asking for. And unfortunately, for so long, corporations have tried to limit their access to the courts. And we just think it's wrong. And we want to encourage others to get involved in this fight because it's the jury system is a something that we should cherish and work hard to preserve.
Linda, in about a minute, something very bothersome about this story is the way academia has gotten behind this movement to reform the justice process. About 30 seconds. Tell me give me your view on that.
Well, you know, I can give you an example. George Mason University here in near Washington has an effort that they it's kind of a reception that they put on once a month where they invite a pro civil justice reform person in to talk. And they buy up this one great barbecue restaurant, and everybody comes and listens to the propaganda. And they do it on a monthly basis.
So what they do is they shape even academia to where it looks more legitimate when a university comes out and supports tort reform. Linda Lipsen, thank you for joining us. Thank you for being out there on this fight, okay?